everyone, and thank you for inviting me to this event. It looks very good. I see so many familiar faces and who are our always friends and always been with the community. And I feel very excited and energetic when I see the people from the community who works for the community, who keep the community first. My name is Shahana Masum, and I am, my background is Bangladeshi American, but I've been here quite long. I came here when I was my teenage, and I am running for district leader. It's a Democrat Party assembly 61, assembly district 61, female district leader. Let me tell you a little bit. I know many of you, we already know what is it, but let me tell you what is this. It looks like really little teeny tiny things. It's every party, they have a district leader. It goes by the every assembly district. So assembly district is the one is, this is the one is goes like in a state, it's a state leaders. And assembly district, every assembly district has a one male, one female. And if any assembly district has many county committee members, though, then they have maybe more than one, and you know, one pair or two pairs. But the district, the county I am running, and that's the district, assembly district 61, we have one female and one male district leader. So every district leader, what they do, they have to make sure a couple of things. They need to make sure that every voter, Democrat, if it's a party election. So I'm running on Democrat Party, and I'm gonna be, you know, this position, we have to make sure that every Democrat voter being served with justly and equal, you know, have the equity for, you know, serving them. And also we have to make sure that the politician who is already been elected, they are following, they are listening to the voters, and they are not, and this is district leader is kind of bridge between the voters and the leaders. So district leader also has to make sure that when the leaders are not following according to the party, also the listening to the voter. And also district leader has a authority to appoint county committee members. I know you guys are many of you saying, what is this county committee member? County committee member is the power. You know, today is Jamal Bowman there. If the county committee endorse him at the first, he wouldn't be need to spend that much money, that much power. These county committee members, all county committee members, they elect who is going to be the party nomination, who is going to get the party nomination, as it goes by the election with the party county committee. So that's why it is very important. So it's like a first stage. Many of the people in our community, we know, they don't even know what is the county committee, and they go for run for the office. And that's why they have to go extra mile and to, you know, challenge the opponent. So what I'm doing, this is the district leader. Also district leader will be watch out the finance, how the finance being handled, the party finance. As you know, we are here, like most of us, we are like connected with the international. So we are not only thinking about United States, we are also thinking about how United States react with the international relation. This is a start from here. If we make sure, like Democrat Party, they are putting their money where it needs to be, believe me, you need to be run for district leader, you should be a county committee members. This is the grassroots of the party. So what is I'm running for Actually, I wasn't really ready for it, and I never had no idea. I never had no plan to run. Anybody asks me, even Dr. Halil Matnu, a couple of times he whispered me, "When are you gonna run?" I said, "No, never, never, never." And this is the one just happened. We saw one of the female district leader. Our disposition get open, and they request me, my assembly member. He's also first Muslim in Albany, that's Charles Falls. And he just called me, and my son was there too, Suleiman. And he said, "Hey, would you like to be run for district leader? I will nominate you." And I was like, "Okay, why not?" I don't know why it comes to me. And then after a while, we saw that in Staten Island, Richmond County, we don't have colored people. Only we have some African American people, but they're very old age. Another one, no brown people. Forget about Muslims. Only the Muslim was Charles, and especially the hijabis. And I've been in Staten Island last 18, 19 years, and I was subjected to racial attack by the NYPD. The every day was my Staten Island subjected to the hate because of my hijab. And my children, they are the one of the product of Islamophobia, how they reacted to me and my family. But alhamdulillah, I never changed myself. I stay who I am, and you accept me or not. But so far, I am also running under the endorsement of county committee. That means the county also endorsed me after so many, interview and other things. But this is the one. So please make dua for me. It's not sounds big, it's little. But if I could be there, I would be the one talk like a Bernie, because I'm also Bernie Sanders delegate. I was Bernie Sanders delegate. So inshallah it will bring big change. And I will be the first hijabi in the whole New York State, district leader as well. Thank you.